Sea of mud at 42.02 degrees north, 74.08 degrees west. There was a walk in space that 400,000 long-haired pilgrims in and out of sweatshirts called the greatest weekend since the creation.
Dig it, dig it!
Fire!
came to be known as the Woodstock Nation. In search of rock, acid, pot, peace, and just being together, 400,000 Americans between 15 and 25 flocked to Max Yasker's dairy farm at Bethel, New York, for a weekend with Sly and the Family Stone, Country Joe and the Fish, Janis Joplin, the Jefferson Airplane, Santana, Crosby, Stills, and Nash, The Who, Joan Baez, and Arlo Guthrie, among others. The festival was declared a disaster area, and if there had been a riot, the commission that would have investigated it would have probably blamed negligent planning by the promoters, lack of water, food, medical and sanitary facilities, and stormy weather. It would have cited also the abundance of marijuana, some hard drugs, communal living, and the exploitation of thousands of turned away ticket holders who never got their $18 back. Yet there was no violence, relatively little illness for a population of this size. Three people died, two were born, and in a rare happening, even the police got rave notices. There was some paranoia. The establishment was blamed by some for having seeded the clouds causing the downpour. Some critics of the festival called it an orgy organized by the communists, and the promoters ended up suing each other. At the end, Farmer Yasker stood on center stage and saluted the multitude.
I'm a farmer. I don't know how to speak to 20 people at one time, let alone a crowd like this. This is the largest group of people ever assembled in one place. But I think you people have proven something to the world, that 500,000 kids can get together and have 3 days of fun and music, and have nothing but fun and music. And I